have a particular interest in the history of rhythm and blues and soul music and where it came from and where it's going and what's happened to popular music and all these musical things. Because my family has been in the music production and the music composition business for 120 years in America. My grandfather was a ragtime composer in the teens and 20s. And my mother was a jazz aficionado whose friends Barney Josephson and John Hammond started Cafe Society and bought Billie Holiday the first dress she wore in Harlem. And so I grew up on inspired, heartfelt music, both from the ragtime period and the jazz period. And in the last 10 years, I discovered through ancestral genealogy from my grandfather's side that I came from Germany and found that my German relatives actually did not come in through New York, but they came in through New Orleans and went up the Mississippi River in the 1860s and settled along the Mississippi, but were shoon and shot out of there with the Ku Klux Klan as Jewish settlers and had to move out of Melville, Louisiana. And they all went together to a small town in Georgia called Macon. So I visited my cousins in Macon, Georgia 5 years ago, and they took me to the cemetery where my great-grandmother's buried next to the plots of the Allman Brothers. So when I tell you it got creepy and wonderful, it got even better the next day because we were the guest of the Otis Redding family at the Otis Redding Museum in Macon, where I met with Carla, Otis's daughter, and Justin, his grandson, and had time to share stories because I had been involved with the Smithsonian archiving and preserving American rhythm and blues music for perpetuity with Steve Cropper. And so they were interested in what I was doing and I was interested in what they were doing, and we're all just one big happy family. So I am thrilled to be here today to share some of this music with you, with my friends in the old school Revue, because these folks, men and women, have been doing this music as long as we have for the past half a century. And what Brian said about the quality and integrity of this music bears repeating. You're all here for the same reason, is that you love music. And there's something about this kind of heartfelt blues music that you heard explained where it came from and why it is the music of the land, the music of the people, the angst, the challenges, the life experiences that create the songs and the messages behind the true feelings of the people behind them. And I think it's illuminating and thrilling for me to have an erudite, scholarly author like Brian come up here and save me from boring you with my litany on it, because he really has done it on a tour basis from a standpoint of both a musician and an author and speaker and a guy with incredible gifts for understanding the evolution of this music in the American culture. And it's interesting stuff, and we call it, we're speaking about music, and I don't know if it's up there, I guess it is. The concept of speaking of music is something that came about a few years ago, actually, when COVID hit and nobody had a gig. And so we began to, and on top of the polarity and difficulty of talking to people who are not politically like-minded, like a lot of us are, it was difficult sometimes to have conversations. So we would gather together with people and have moderated speaking panels about music and talk about the music. And it was obvious that this is a language that we all speak and people enjoy talking about music. So enough said of that. I want to take you to Memphis, Tennessee right now on the first stop on this road trip and tell you just a few observations about Memphis and why this music will fit and sound like Memphis. The backdrop, as Brian said, of the segregated town and the segregated South made it ironic that a lot of soul music came out of Memphis, Tennessee. And it's one of its chief components and important ensembles was three or four high school kids from Memphis named Booker T. Jones, Duck Dunn, and Steve Cropper, and Al Jackson, who formed a high school band called the Marquees. And they were known as the Marquees. They had one of the first hit records on Stax label, followed by a song called Green Onions. So what I would like to do is introduce you to the old school Revue. They will come out, please. And we will perform for you the original hit record of Green Onions.